Hey. Hello, Greg, everyone. Everyone's on the illegal starting soon.
Okay.
That's on the illegal thing starting soon. Because it's going, we've only had it before it started too. There's a text up saying it's starting.
Thank you.
154 days ago, the kickoff of the 2015 Group 10 season. Now, September 13, 2015, we're down to the final two teams. Orange Sims against Lithgow Workies here at Orange's Wade Park. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Group 10 Premier League Grand Final. My name is Ben Harris, calling the action alongside with Brian and Vanawaka as we just wait for the two sides to come out. The referees are out there. Jason Whitney, the man in the middle, refereeing his first Group 10 Grand Final. His touch judges will be Nick Lander and Nathan Blanchard. But I bring Brian in the commentary box. Brian, mate, after first since kickoff on April 12, we've down to the final two teams, the best two teams in the competition. Sims Minor Premiers taking on Lithgow Workies. How do you make this game so far?
It's going to be an unbelievable game, isn't it? Good afternoon, Ben. Afternoon, people at home. It's going to be a fantastic grand final. What a day it's been so far. We've had three different grand finals. This might be the fourth, the big one, as the Orange Sims coming out to a warm reception from their home crowd here this afternoon at Wade Park. Can they go for what is going to be another grand final victory for them this afternoon? Didn't make it to the grand final last year. It was between, of course, Cowra and Bathurst and Pats. But this year, two new teams, the grand final is going to be fantastic. Orange Sims gunning for their fourth, I think, in 6 years. So it's going to be very interesting to see if they can try and make it work here this afternoon.
Yes, this is Sims' fifth appearance since in the grand final since 2010. As they've been led out by their captain, Ben McAlpine. The team for Orange Sims is fullback Tim Bassman. Wingers are Samesi Katoa and Robbie Mortimer. Three is Jermone Harrison. Ben McAlpine is number four. The halves pairing is Matt Rose and Mick Sullivan. The props is Cam Jones and Simon Osborne. Hooker is Sam Hill. Number 11 is Riley Law. 12 is Trent Rose. And number 13 is Kieran Bubb. The bench is number 14, Scott Sullivan. 15, Ben Gosper. 16, Luke Petrie. And 17, Wayne Collett. As the Lithgow Workmen's Club come out, they've been led by their captain, number 10, Chris Rhodes. Going through their lineup, number 1 is fullback Antonio Ali. Number 2, Joel O'Brien. Number 4 is Jono Van Veen. Number 17 is Kieran Brisak. He has come in late. In breaking news, Kieran Croft, the number 3 for Lithgow, is out of the game. As number 5, Sip Ali, Ben Stewart, Wade Egan. Number 8, Brendan West, Ernest Allo, Chris Rhodes, Corey Realmont, number 11. Brendan Van Veen's 12 and Alex Byrne is number 13 as we get ready for the national anthem for this game between Lithgow Workies and Orange Sims. As we get set for the Group 10 Premier League Grand Final, I'll just finish that Lithgow Workies team for you. As I said, the lock forward is Alex Byrne, number 13. The bench is Steve Lang. Number 15 is Harry Knight. Number 16 is Coops Ali. And number 18 is Mitch Cates. Just repeating, number 3 for Lithgow, Kieran Croft, has been ruled out late for injury, a hamstring injury. That's a big blow for Workies so early on, Brian. Without a ball being kicked, they've lost one of their most impact players who was so superb last week against Mudge in the preliminary final.
Yeah, that could well play a difference in this grand final here this afternoon. Of course, a lot of the talk heading into today's grand final has been the talk about Jono Van Veen. Will he not play after a little scuffle late last week? He is in the squad lining up in jersey number 4. Looking forward to seeing how he's going to play today. It's going to be a fantastic match. The crowd is really coming out in force here this afternoon in Norwich here at Wade Park. They're going to really try and get behind their Orange Sims side here, but it's going to be a great game. Really looking forward to this one. Orange Sims coming into it probably as favourites. Lithgow Workies a little bit behind, but anything can play out over the course of these next 80 minutes. Really looking forward to having it all here at Wade Park this afternoon.
Well, these two teams are no strangers to each other. Come big big game. It's been grand final day. This is, in fact, the third meeting in 5 years that Lithgow have played Sims in the grand final. In 2011, in Orange at Endeavour Oval, Orange Sims won that clash 30 points to 12. Then 12 months later, in 2012, at Tony Lacetti Sports Ground, Lithgow pumped Orange Sims 40 points to 14, the biggest victory in the last 15 years of a Group 10 grand final. As Jason Whitney's just waiting for to commence the game, Wade Egan looking to get the game on and away. And here we go, kickoff in the Group 10 to his new grand final for Premier League. And it's gone out on the full. Not a great start by Lithgow. Well, Wade Egan's kick has gone out on the full. Trent Rose has put one foot on the sideline, but he's caught the ball on the full, and in those rules, he's had to kick out on the full as Ben McAlpine, the big right boot of Ben McAlpine, sends that ball down 20 metres, and Sims have first attacking opportunity on their 30-metre line. This is now Trent Rose. He's been warned by tackled by Corey Wilmot. He's going to be a big player, Trent Rose. He and his brother, Matt Rose. He's now, speaking of Matt Rose, he's got the ball now, looking at Kieran Bubb. Kieran Bubb takes it on, the young 23-year-old. He's been one of the great young guns for Sims for a number of years, but he's come of age in the last couple of years. Mick Sullivan picks it up from his ankle tips. Pass it on to, that's Cameron Jones, another one of the big players. That's one of the big players there. In fact, no, it's Simon Osborne. Now Sullivan looks around. He gives it out to Matt Rose. They've drawn to the left. Matt Rose leads up with his brother Trent. And Corey Wilmot's hit just unfortunately bounces off that tackle. And Trent Rose is wrapped up in 8 metres to go. Rose puts a little grubble in off the legs of Brendan West. And it's been kicked again by Rose, but picked up by the fullback from Lithgow and Tony Arley. So, Brian, I would have to say Lithgow off the hook in that first set of six.
Yeah, under the pressure there, nice and early there for the Lithgow workies, but they handled that nicely. Good, strong defence. When we talk of defence, though, Orange Sims have tended to have the real good defensive side of the 2015 season. So it's going to be interesting, and you can already see that they're pushing Lithgow workies back in these nice early stages of this first half.
You mentioned that throughout the season, both teams are so equal. Obviously, Orange Sims, they only lost to two matches throughout this season, one to Mudgee and the other one was to Lithgow Workies. That was back in Orange, in fact, here at this very ground. Lithgow won 22 points to 12, and in their Premier League final meeting only a couple of weeks ago, Sims won that match 18 points to 16 as Wade Egan's boot comes off, kick off the side of the boot, and Robbie Mortimer, the young of the Mortimer clan, his older brother Daniel, the Gold Coast Titans player, he's actually in crowd today watching his younger brother go around, and unfortunately said Robbie's other brother, Tim, who's been just had knee surgery, he's in the ground watching, supporting, cheering his team on. This is now Cameron Jones wearing the yellow headgear, the number 8, the 20-year-old. He's going to be hard to stop. He and Simon Osborne will be the go-to men for Orange Sims. Mick Sullivan is calling for it. He gets the ball. He puts his short ball in, and he gets tackled. He gets tackled there. Held it up. He thought he was going to give it to Riley Law, but Sullivan got taken down. Now Sullivan gets the kick. He puts a chip in through. Sam Hill chases down. Then Joel O'Brien's got to do quite well to pick that up, and which he does, and he's been brought down 5 minutes out from the Lithgow Workies. Workies at the moment are under the pump. Sims have had the ball also inside their territory. You see a big run there by Corey Wilmot. As Lithgow slowly work their way up the field, this is number 4. That was Jono van Veen. As I said, it was an interesting week for Jono van Veen, having been sent off in that Premier League final win over Mudgee. He's been freed. He was cleared to play by the Group 10 judiciary. Now this is Brendan West sporting a Ned Kelly style beard. You can't miss that beard. Now this is Ben Stewart on the right foot. He puts the pressure down. Back down the board, Robbie Mortimer. He gets it on his 30-metre line. He runs on the field. He gets tackled by Corey Wilmot. Great little chase there by Corey Wilmot. And referee Jason Whitney told him to play the ball back, as this is now Cam Jones. He's been tackled by a handful of workies defenders, including Wade Egan, the halfback, and Alex Byrne over the top. Back to Mick Sutherland. This is Ben McAlpine, the dangerous player, Ben McAlpine. He was the 2013 David Scott Medal recipient for being the man of the match in the 2013 Group 10 Grand Final, which Sims defeated their cross-time rivals, Orange Hawks, 22 points to 14. He plays the ball on the 45-metre line. This is big Simon Osborne, the former country seconds player. He gets dumped on his back on the 40-metre line. Matt Rose does another little shifty little kick there. And Antonio Ali, he's up to the challenge, runs that ball and craps on the... and catches on the full, and he picks up and has a run around. And Tony Ali and his brothers Sip and Coops played first year playing for Lithgow Workies. They also played in the Group 10 Grand Final last year for Bathurst St. Pat's, which was won by the men in blue and white, 34 points to 12 over in Cowra. As the ball's getting played, this is the first opportunity for Lithgow. Monaghan getting a sniff. This is Brendan Van Veen. He makes a big run out and he's been tackled inside Sims' half on their 45-metre line. 5 minutes gone. It's Orange Sims nil, Lithgow Workies nil. Ben Harris and Brian Vandenwacker in the commentary box for Western Rams TV, calling the Group 10 to his new grand final here on Sunbay Wade Park here in Orange. As there's a bit of a... Not sure what happened there. John O'Van Veen was calling for a penalty. He got taken out. This is Stewart. But anyway, this is Ali now. Gives it out to Brisak. He makes great running through. He's linked up with Ben Stewart and great tackle there. Ball and all tackled by Tim Bassman, the fullback, the last line of the fence. And now Lithgow on the attack. Ernest Allo, he goes left. Back to Egan. Long ball out to Brendan Van Veen. Van Veen, he's got Chris Rose, the captain. He looks for the offload, but he gets wrapped up there. Great tackle there by Sims. But Lithgow, first opportunity in their own half. They looked pretty good, didn't they, Brian?
Yeah, Lithgow looking really good, nice and early here at the moment, the attack. Looking better than probably Orange Sims at the moment. Sims, though, doing well in defence. They were a little bit open there towards the right-hand side, but thankfully they got away with it just then. But a nice little breakaway for Lithgow. Looking good early here, actually. Let's see if Sims can try and get out of their own half right here, right now.
Well, Simon Osborne again. That's his second here. He gets the offload. You've got to be careful with those offloads. And Sammy Hill, the youngster, wearing the headgear. He was in that, obviously, in that game in 2011 playing for Orange Sims. He was a hooker in that grand final last time these met in Orange. And the big run there that looked like Kieran Bubb. He gets tackled on Sims's on his own 40-metre line. Cam Jones looking for an offload. He gives it to Trent Rose. Rose, bit of a little shimmy. He gets tackled there and again by Ernest Allo. And an absolute one-on-one tackle there. Allo at marker. This is the Hill. Gives it to Simon Osborne. The former MMA fighter who's playing in his also first year for Sims. And Matt Rose, he decides to go deep. And he turns Allo in front. And Joel O'Brien, the number two for Lithgow, has to clean it up. And he does so. And he's 2 metres outside his own line as the ball goes down. This is number four. That's John O'Van Veen, who does a bit of a hit up and gets tackled on his 12-metre line. Killen Brisak, he makes another dummy half run. That's O'Brien. This is Sip Ali. Again, he was playing for St. Pat's this time last year. He knows what it's like to win a grand final, having won with the Bathurst Club last year. At the moment, the big Sims are looking very, very well in defence. They're moving up very quickly. Lithgow, this is their fifth tackle. Whitney's has put the arm in. Unfortunately, there's a knock on. And Sip Ali, unfortunately, has knocked the ball on, trying to play it, and now Sims have a perfect opportunity inside Lithgow's half with only 8 minutes gone, I should say. Sims lead nil all, but Sims have the ball inside Lithgow's half on the 35-metre line.
It's going to be the second time now for Lithgow to try and defend a set of six here from Orange. Of course, we saw Orange straight off that kickoff have a nice set of six inside their own half. So let's wait and see how Orange Sims will play this. I feel like Mortimer's going to have a big afternoon here, the number five, the winger, because pretty well nearly all the times Lithgow have kicked it over to Mortimer. So he's going to have his work cut out this afternoon. They were looking over to the right kick then, two workies, but before that knock-on was handled. So it's going to be interesting to see how Sims can fare up here at the moment. Very early stages of this fantastic grand final so far. Very equal, you would say.
Osborne needs a big run there. He's on the brought down on the 10-metre line, right in front of the six. Hill gives out the Matt Rose. Matt Rose links up with his brother. Great run there by Trent Rose, but up to the task was Corey Wilmot, who just grabbed Trent Rose and took him down. And we've got it. And whoa, it's a forward pass. Jason Whitney, the referee, has got the call from one of his touch judges. I think it was Nick Lander on the far side. He called that ball forward. And Lithgow, well, frantic pace. There's just a bit of cloud cover just come over the field. As I said, it's been a glorious day here at Wade Park. It's top of 18 degrees. Sun is out, but even though it says it's 18 degrees on the mercury, it feels a lot hotter when you're down on ground level. Feels like it's even low 20s, maybe mid 20s. So it's going to be a very tough task for the big props of Lithgow. It's going to be a hot day for them. Chris Groves plays with it. And this is Egan. The SGE ball player for Penrith Panthers. Had a fantastic year for the Panthers in the under-18s competition. He now gives the ball out. He gives it out to Antonio Ali, looking for support. He finds support back to Ernest Allo, and that's the Lifko player brought down. Sims, I must say, they've had a lot of the territory in Sims' favour. And Brendan West bounces off Ben McAlpine, which is no easy task. But Ben McAlpine, he's a tall fella and a solid unit as himself. And Brendan West just made him look like an under-8 player. And it's a big kick there by Ben Stewart. Bassman has to run back and collect it, which he does. Lets it bounces, but he eventually collects it and he gets tackled by Sip Ali, number 5 for Lifko. And this is Samisi Katoa. He's not afraid to take a run from his own half, and also he's a solid defender. Look for him to have to get around, especially when the trial line's begging. He can put the ball down. This is Robbie Mortimer. He does a little jig, does a little dance, but he gets wrapped up by Alex Byrne, the number 13 from Lithgow. Sam Hill offloads up to that's number 13 to Kieran Bubb. And Sims at the moment, Sullivan decides to chip it behind the Lithgow defence, and Ali just, well, there's no urgency from Antonio Ali, and he's got to do quite well to get out of this half, and he's in goal, which he's done. He's spun around and he's been brought in the touch. That is great defence and a great kick and chase there by Orange Sims. Kieran Bubbles down there. I think Samisi Katoa was down there as well, but Antonio Ali, I've got to say, Brian, that he didn't show much urgency to get that ball, even though the Sims defenders were breathing down his necks.
No, great kick and chase there from Sims. Straight away, they went straight down, marked him, put him hard, and ultimately they came out on top. Then did Sims once again. They have been the side so far in 2015 in terms of the defence, and they're showing that here at the moment. So once again, Sims really got the upper hand in defensive-wise, and they're slowly turning the screws early in this first half at the moment. Still a long way to go, but you've got to say that Sims have got the upper hand nice and early.
Yes, the crowd, as I said, the crowd's, they're all packed in at the moment. The grandstand is packed, and as I said, a kick going, is it going to bounce out on the sideline? And it does. Well, Sims are going to get the feed here. Well, that's a uncharacteristically mistake by Sims. Trent Rose letting the ball bounce and unfortunately put so much pressure on his teammate Jermone Harrison, who unfortunately could not regather the bounce, and Lifko being let off there with a dropout. They have now got the scrum feed 20 on their 20 metre line. They'll be looking to play the game in their Sims's half. They haven't done so. Well, they've only done it once so far this season. This game, I should say, not this season. And this is Antonio Ali. He just shapes up. He gets his opposite number, Tim Bassman, takes a tackle. And unfortunately, in the process, well, it's a good tackle there by Bassman and Mick Sullivan, because in the process of getting tackled, Antonio Ali has dropped the ball. And as we saw in the first division grand final, there was a lot of nerves earlier on, and the Premier League boys are not shy away from that fact. They also showed plenty of nerves. So obviously Sims again on the attack inside Lithgow's half. Can they put all this pressure into points? As Matt Rose, he's got the ball. He does a little goose step, does a little step, and comes and gets tackled there. Great, sorry, unfortunately it's a penalty. And Corey Wilmot was never onside, and JC Whitney gets a penalty, and Matt Rose looking for a quick tap. Can't really, and Whitney's just told him to hold on, wait till I'm ready. And Sims will be looking at the touch. And they've decided to go for the tap instead. And this is Cameron Jones. He walks through and makes about 10 metres. He gets brought down on the 10-metre line. Nil all. Sims between work. He's in the group 10 to his new grand final for Premier League. Mike Sullivan's with short ball. And that's to Riley Law. Riley Law back from his one-week suspension. He's injected straight into this team. With Logan Polkingholton injured. And unfortunately, oh, it's a Semi Katoa has been turned upside down. My referee Whitney says okay, and it's a big run there to Sullivan. Long ball out to Rose. Rose looks for Trent Rose, and this is his Burrow. This is Trent. He gets brought down again. Again, Sims are tackling on the left flank. Quick crater ball by Matt Rose is there. Jermone Harrison. He gets tackled. He gets caught, and there's a penalty. Two back-to-back penalties for Sims. Well, they might have to settle. Will they go for the try? Whitney, well, it's probably not a good opportunity for a goal. And Matt Rose-Rotley said, no, we'll go try and get the try here. But back-to-back penalties, Brian. You reckon the pressure is starting to get the lift go at the moment?
Yeah, definitely. I'm looking at Sullivan at the moment. He's really mixing it up at the moment in terms of the short balls and the long balls as well. And it's just got out of touch, unfortunately, there for the Sims. It almost opened up for them in the wing. But, Sullivan, watch the number seven at the moment. He's really mixing it up, which is nice to see.
Trent Rose there, the backhander, the Benji Marshall-like no-look pass to the backhand from Trent Rose, could not find the mark on Robbie Mortimer. And if I had grabbed that, I'm sure Robbie Mortimer would have scored a try there in the corner and would have opened first points. So here you go, another scrum, 15 minutes gone in the first half of the Tui's new Group 10 Grand Final in the Premier League. Orange Sims nil, Lithgow Workies nil, Ben Harris and Brian Vanawaka in the commentary box for Reston Rams TV. And it's a strong tackle, and unfortunately there's a penalty there. Going, bit of a spear tackle going above the horizontal, and Jason Whitney had no other option but to penalise the Sims side for a dangerous tackle. So Lithgow being let off the hook there.
Much like what we saw in the first division, isn't it, Ben? A lot of mistakes, a lot of penalties coming through in the early stages of this game. So a little bit scrappy so far, but Orange is still sitting on top so far, you got to say. Only very early, but defensive-wise, let's see what Orange can do this time by as they barge their way through over the 30-metre line.
Yeah, that's the new look, Brendan Van Veen. He's like, he got a haircut during the week. Looking good. Chris Rose off the look around. No-look pass, and boy has gone play on, and Corey Wilman has to pick up the scraps, and then he has met up with a couple of defenders from Sims, and he rolls over, and on the 40-metre line, Trent Rose there, and Trent Rose, Jason Whitney's told him to get up and play the ball properly. So Carl Williams has been pulled back to play the ball. Trent Rose and acting at marker. This is Brendan West. A tearaway youngster and has matured in 2015. He's one of the form props of the year. I mean, one of the big reasons why Lithgow have done so well, where they finished second on the ladder and now they play Sims in the grand final. He was a had a great game against Mudgee last week in the preliminary final, which Lithgow won 24 points to 16 at home. This is the captain, Chris Rose. He's brought down on the 35-metre line. Fifth tackle. What will they do? Are they going to go to the air? Jay Wade Egan puts a little grubby kick straight in the hands of Simon Osborne, just like a slip, and Simon Osborne says, thank you very much, and I'll get tackled on the 25-metre line. And Cam Jones now is looking for Osborne's prop forward teammate. And this is Samesi Katoa. He's running high. He gets brought up by Lithgow defence. Both these sides, I've said, there's been nothing in it for these two sides of it. They've met three times this season. Sims defeated Lithgow in Lithgow on a cold Friday night a couple of months ago, 16 points to 14. In the return fixture, the Workies got up 22 points to 12 here at Wade Park. And a fortnight ago, Sims won the prelim final, the major semi-final, I should say, 18 points to 16. This is Sepali. He's had a few runs, the winger. Never afraid to run away from the ball. And this is big Alex Burns. He gets brought down by his opposite forward, Cameron Jones, and Ben Stewart going straight to the air, and Robbie Mortimer under the high ball again, safe as house, and he pushes off and gets tackled. Great cover of the fence there by Keelan Brezak. Obviously, Keelan Brezak coming in at the last minute for Kieran Croft, who was out with a hamstring injury prior to the match. So there was late changes for Lithgow. But I must say, Keelan Brezak, the 20-year-old, has done very well so far slotting in on that right side.
A lot of it, like I mentioned before, they're really tackling and looking at Robbie Mortimer, because three out of the four times they kicked it down to the orange side left of the field. So Mortimer's going to be, like I mentioned, under the pump today as he plays it from dummy half there and looks through to the centre of the pitch once again. But these props are going to be big time, aren't they, for both sides at the moment if they want to try and break through. They're having to smash their way through defensive lines at the moment. But, watch for Robbie Mortimer. They're really tackling him at the moment on the left-hand side for the Sims.
And Rose goes straight to the air. That's gone so high, it might have snow on it. But, great take there by the 24-year-old Joel O'Brien. Showed no fear, even though the Sims defenders breathing down his neck, and Brendan Van Veen runs it up and gets tackled on the 30-metre line. Nil all, Sims against Workies in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final for 2015 here at a picturesque Wade Park in Orange. Ben Harris and Brian Van Wacker in the commentary box for Western Rams TV here for you. We've already had we've had a fantastic day so far here at Orange in Group 10. We had in the league 10. It's John Van Veen trying to make a brush. Then he gets tackled on the 45-metre line. And looking for a quick play of the ball. Lithgow complaining for a slow play of the ball. This is Brendan West. He offloads out. Gives it to Ali. Now this is number 11, Corey Wilmont. And Matt Rose just drags him a little about with the help of Jerome Harrison. Stewart goes to the air. Tim Bassman, what have you got? Can you take this? Eyes on the ball. And he's let it bounce on. It looked like Mike got taken out, but it's been bounced on. And fortunately for Sims, it has bounced to the way right in the arms of Trent Rose, who picked it up on the 25-metre line and now brought down first tackle for Orange Sims. This is Simon Osborne. Big charge from him. But as I said, he's played for numerous clubs, and he's played in grand finals for numerous clubs. We've got to think about Bathurst Panthers back in the early 2000s. In 2010, he played for the Dragons when Sims won 23 points to 16. He's been away from Group 10 for a while, but now back in 2015, and he's done very, very well this season, obviously being the second place in the Group 10 Player of the Year, which was he was runner-up to the St. Pat's hooker, Benjamin John.
That was a big kick and chase then from the Lithgow Workies. I mean, Bassman was right under the pump there. He had three big boys right in front of him. It was going to be awfully difficult for him to actually get up and jump, but it was unlucky there for the Workies because that ball, once it bounced, it could have gone absolutely anywhere. So a great kick and chase from Lithgow Workies, really putting Tim under the pump there at the fullback.
Mick Sullivan gets squashed in two tackles. The two big props, Rose and West, crush the halfback of Sims. And Tony Ali grabs that ball on the full, and he rakes it back out on the 15-metre line and gets tackled. And as I said, this is our fourth game of Group 10. We've had three crackerjacks of matches in the first game. In the league tag, if you just joined us, Bathurst St. Pat's defeated Bathurst Panthers, the defending premiers, 14 points to 4. In the under-18s, the dominant Orange Hawks went back-to-back. They defeated Mudgee Dragons, 42 points to 12. And in the first division, Orange Sims also went back-to-back, 10 points to 6, defeating the Bathurst Panthers. As we're just 18 and a half minutes to go with Orange Sims 0, Lithgow Workies 0. Most of the match has been played in the middle of the park. Both sets of forwards doing the hard yards, and that is number 15 for Lithgow, Harry Knight. And there's a few more changes happening for Lithgow. Brendan West comes on and Coops Ali, the number 16, he comes on. Hopefully for Coops Ali, he can get an early birthday present for him. His birthday is actually, in fact, on Thursday, and we see a penalty. We see a penalty for Orange Sims. Another high shot going up above the shoulders. And Ben McAlpine, he's going to reef this as far as he can. He's got a big right boot, which he does. And he's on his own 40-metre line, and that is a terrific kick. That is a fantastic kick by Ben McAlpine, the former Group 10 Player of the Year. He would kick that from his own 40-metre line, and now Sims are on on Lithgow's 10-metre and are looking fantastic. As we're looking at Sam Hill now, coming up to Matt Rose. He passes over the ball to Mick Sullivan. Sullivan links up with Ben McCarpine, who runs on the right-hand side. He looks at the offload, which he does. He gets tackled there. So Missy Katoa has a run from dummy half. He gets tackled. Roughly about 5 metres out from Lithgow's half. I said, Sims, this is not the first time they've been inside this Lithgow's 20. They've been in there quite a few times. And Mick Sullivan's bullet pass to Sam Hill could not be grasped by the young hooker, and he's dropped the ball, and that was picked up by number 6, Ben Stewart. And this is Killen Brisak, who's running on to get the ball in, but unfortunately been met by Simon Osborne, and also that's number 16 on who from Orange Sims. That is Ben Gosper. No, Luke Petrie, I must say.
Once again, Sullivan really looking for those balls, isn't he, in the centre of that park, as we've got another penalty here going in this match. But yeah, once I said, Sullivan's really looking for those different sort of balls, whether it be short, long. He's really mixing it up there in the centre of the field, so it's good to see. And he's going to be key for these Orange Sims, particularly late in the second half in this game. The way that it's going at the moment is going to be very, very tight. So there's going to be those key moments for both sides that is really going to deter the tie of what's going to happen here this afternoon and who's going to walk away with this Group 10 Premiership this afternoon.
Yeah, talking about key moments, and obviously Sims are just giving away a penalty there. It's been very tight, hasn't it, Brian? Both Sims have probably had the better advantage in terms of territory. They've had a little more ball than Lithgow. What would Lithgow have to do? Obviously, they've got the penalty here. Ben Stewart just reefs it down. What will Lithgow have to do to try and get back into this, or to shift the momentum and get back into this game?
They're going to have to try and find the holes and, you know, work it out wide, try and really belt their way through the middle and just try and make metres, because at the moment, that's what they've been struggling for. Sims have really had them down in their own half a lot of this game so far. So if they can try and find those little breaks out wide, then I reckon Workies might be able to try and work something here. But you can see at the moment, they're just trying to smash their way out through the centre. And we'll wait and see what they can do. Those kicks as well. It looks like a few of the backs there for Orange Sims are a little bit waverly under those kicks. So we'll have to wait and see how they go. But a few good metres being made here for the Workies. This might present themselves with an opportunity.
As Chris Rhodes plays the ball back to Ernest Allo. Ernest Allo looks up and gives it out of the back. Great take there by Brandon Van Veen over the top. And then flick pass back to Antoni Ali, who gives it to Jonathan Van Veen. Jonathan Van Veen's running quick. Great tackle there by Tim Bassman. Desperation stuff there by the fullback. And unfortunately, he's been hurt in the process. Bassman's down. He has not come up. And Jono Van Veen, that is was a fantastic tackle by Bassman, putting his body on the line against a bigger opposition play in Jono Van Veen. And Van Veen, well, he's loving more, hate him. He's a terrific player, Jono Van Veen. Always wears his heart on his sleeve. He's a passionate player too. But it was a great little work there by Brendan Van Veen, who got the ball above his head, ran through the hole, put a little flick pass to Antonio Ali, and the fullback linked up with Jono Van Veen, and Jono Van Veen made a break down the left-hand side, but unfortunate for Lithgow, and lucky for Sims, I should say, Tim Bassman put the body on the line and took Jono Van Veen into touch. Referee Jason Whitney and his touch judge Nick Lander just having a bit of a word. Whitney's just going to call out. He's just calling out Ben McAlpine, and that's Samesi Katoa as well, who's been caught out. Can't really say what I saw down there. I'm not too sure. Did you see anything there, Brian, in that tackle? Obviously, Tim Bassman got flattened and he stayed down, but was there anything negative or sinister in that tackle?
Yeah, couldn't really see much from our vantage point. There was about five players on top of each other, so hard to determine from here, but words just being said there between referee and player. But once again, those Workies just trying to work it out wide. They found a little bit of a hole there out wide towards the left-hand side for the Workies, and it almost worked for them. They almost made the deadlock, broke the deadlock, I should say, in this fantastic game so far. But it's going to be interesting. If any one of these two teams can try and break through right on the stroke of half-time, then that's going to really change the momentum of this game, particularly once we get into the second half.
Well, it's coming to the point that, you know, we've only got 15 minutes left in the first half, that obviously first points are really important in any game, whoever scores first points, but it's now, we're so close to half time, whoever gets the first points puts him in the box seat for the rest of the game, would you think?
Yeah, that's exactly right. And the messages at half time are going to be very, very interesting towards both sides. Let's see what Sims can do though, because they're going to have to really fight this set of six here, and this is going to really test their defence as they push him back right on their own line.
Yes, Brendan Van Veen, big run from the tap off, and he gets tackled and out foot. Well, dear oh dear. Wow. I was just about to say, this is perfect opportunity for Lithgow. They haven't had that much of a look inside Sims' own 20. And fresh from a penalty that Lithgow got from the tap, Brendan Van Veen, which was a great run, he got brought down just in front of the line. He's knocked the ball on. A cardinal sin in any game of football, let alone a grand final. And now Sims, they get the ball. They pass it out to McAlpine, the captain for Sims. He gets tackled on the 15 metres line. This is the first. Jerome Harrison at dummy half. He has a little run. And he gets tackled. Great tackle there by Ben Stewart. Over the top is Corey Wilmont and then Chris Rhodes. And there's the penalty for a second attempt. Oh, it's a bit high. Not a second, it was a bit high. So and a bit of back chat. 10 metres. Corey Wilmont tells referee Jason Whitney what he thought about the decision. Whitney didn't like it, and he's marched him 10 more metres. And now time is off. with the clock at 13 minutes and 56 seconds to go. Workies and Sims locked up. Nil all. Ben Harris, Brian and Vanawaka in the commentary box for Western Rams TV here on the Tui's new Group 10 Grand Final for Premier League.
Workies giving away cheap stuff there, aren't they? I mean, that's the last thing that they needed. Not only to give away a high tackle, but then ultimately 10 metres as well for back chat. I mean, this is only working into the favour of the Sims now, particularly being at the home ground for the Sims. I mean, you can probably hear it at home. These fans are really starting to get into it now, and they can sense the pressure here. They can sense how tight this game is. Boy, oh boy, it's going to be fantastic this second half.
A low, hard kick driven into the sideline, driven into the touch by Ben McAlpine. This is Trent Rose, who's been solid on the left-hand side. He and his brother Matt Rose have been linking up quite well. Luke Petrie, number 16, he's on. He looks like he's on for Sam Hill, which he is. He's playing dummy half. And they keep going on the right. This is Sullivan. Sullivan links up. That's number six. That's number 15, Ben Gosper. Sullivan went to the right. He's switched back to the left to Matt Rose. Rose wanted summing up his options. He runs back to the right. Kicks it out. Puts it out to the 15. That's Gosper again. Wasn't anything happening in that effort for Sims. And Sullivan looking for, and he puts a little chip kick in. Then he gets Reed Gavis. He's looking for a try. First try. Mick Sullivan, the coach of Warren Sims, open the scoring. Put that down. 12 minutes to go. Little chip, Marie Gamma, and Orin Sims, first try for the Green and Golds. They lead Lithgow Workies 4 points to nil.
I'll tell you what, he got lucky there, didn't he, Sullivan? It came off a Workies play, but then he was able to regather it back up, and bit of luck on his side there for Sullivan going over for the first tries right underneath the black dot. You got to feel that Sims will be able to convert this one to go to a 6-0 lead, but just on the strike nearly of half-time, Sims go up to a 4-point lead, and Sullivan, there he is. We were talking about him a moment ago about being the real game-changer of this match. He goes over and gets the first points in the grand final.
Well, I was watching Tim Bassman. It was Tim Bassman, the fullback. He was lurking behind Sullivan. Obviously, it was a planned move for Bassman. Sullivan was a bit like a Billy Slater kick over there in the Queensland State of Origin for Slater. But Sullivan went for the chip. He got charged down by a Lithgow player. Sullivan picks it up, and there was no one in front of him. Does a little dart, and the old legs, there's still some speed in those old legs of his. He's already come out during the week saying he's not going to retire after this match or by injuries. Unfortunately, he's had a great season this year, staying on the field being on the field more times than he in recent years. But he scored to open the first try for Orange Sims. And now Ben McAlpine, 10 metres out, right in front of the six. He should have no problems making this 6-0 in favour of the Green and Golds, in favour of the home side, which was a great, terrific roar when Sullivan scored. And just like that, McAlpine adds the extras. So with only 10 and a half minutes to go until half-time here in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final, the home side, Orange Sims, lead Lithgow Workies 6 points to nil.
Nice little break for the Sims there. So let's see what they can do here late in this first half. Workies have been under the pressure, you've got to say, so far in this opening period of the match because of the strong defence, you would say, from the Sims as we get back underway once again. 10.5 minutes to go. Sims lead 6 points to nil.
And Simon Osborne, he charges it up and he's met there by Corey Wilmot. And in the process, Corey Wilmot has injured himself. He's down, he's clutching his right shoulder. Not sure if it's a collarbone. It's definitely his shoulder. I'm not sure it's popped out. He's carrying it very gingerly and he's in a lot of pain. And there's a big tackle there by Coop Zali and Brendan Van Veen. But unfortunately, it's a penalty. A penalty for Sims. The added insult and injury just to give time up, to give that try only a couple of minutes ago and off the kickoff. So I've got to say, Simon Osborne, he was like a steam train running hard, and Corey Wilmot, full credit to him, met the big guy one-on-one, and unfortunately for Wilmot, he's come off second best. He's clutching at his shoulder, his right shoulder. It looked like he might have had a dislocation or the way how he's carrying it.
Yeah, tough luck there for Wilmot. It looked like, well, I'm no doctor, but that looked like it was sort of out from my position. It looked quite ugly there for Wilmot. So he's going to be taken off the field now. But once again, a little momentum shift here at the moment for the Sims. They're really starting to turn the key here late in this first half. And if they can go into the halftime break with possibly another try, then it's going to make things real difficult for the Workies in the second half.
Wilmot gets taken off the field. He's been escorted off the field by a Lithgow trainer. He's been replaced by number 14, Steve Lang. And there's a kick from McCowboy. Hasn't found touch, has it? No, it has not found touch, though. A big let off there by Lithgow. And Joel O'Brien takes it and gets met up there. Great, good tackle there by Robbie Pornema. Lithgow on the 30, on their own 35-metre line. This is Brezak. He takes a deal with dummy half. Another strong tackle there by Orange Sims. Their defence has been very, very good. Not just in this game, but all season. And Brezak, he's got his pants down around his bow check. And then we see our third strong hit. That is Simon Osborne. He gets up and says, have another run at me, Steve Lang. Welcome to the Group 10 Grand Final. And there's a penalty. Well, it's a penalty to the defending side. A shepherd. And well, when you've got the ball and you give away a penalty when you've got the ball, that's just a no-no. You don't do that. And unfortunately, Lithgow just no communication, what to say, doing a bit of a shepherd. And Bemo Cowbine drills this ball into the sideline. And Sims have got 30 metres to go. And unfortunately, in the process, Sims have knocked the ball on. Unbelievable. So Brian, errors and ill discipline creeping in with only 8.5 minutes to go. 6-0 lead Sims over Lithgow.
What a change of circumstances in the case of about 30 seconds. Unbelievable. But yeah, now it's in favour of the workies here as they try and get out of their own half here on the 30-metre line. But yeah, Sims, both sides are giving away quite cheaply here so far in this first half. And that's going to be one of the messages that both coaches will speak about heading into half time. Is let's stop giving away these cheap penalties. I mean, that seemed to be the word of the afternoon, hasn't it, with this end, also first division earlier on.
Yes, Lithgow, bit of a pass there. This Leaf Lane plays it. This is Coops Ali. The big rig run. He's been a little bit late. And unfortunately, his offload pass to his brother Antonio. And unfortunately, Antonio could not hold it. And now, well, it just seems like every single time Lithgow try and get in front, try and get the rest of the momentum away from Orange Sims, they just do silly things like give away a penalty or drop the ball on. And now Sims on their own 40-metre line with a scrum. Sullivan feeds it with 7.5 minutes to go. Sims and Matt Rose does a little... Vogus notices that there's no one out back, and he kicks a little kick there by Joel O'Brien. Lets it bounce, and he picks it up. Oh, no, he hasn't picked it up. It's Antonio and Ali. Well, I'm not sure what Joel O'Brien was thinking. He let the ball bounce, and then it did not look like had much urgency to get that ball. But here he is now. Beats off 1-2. Gets off two defenders. A third tackle, and there's the penalty. Inside the 10 metres. And Joe Bryan didn't like the tackle from Scott Sullivan. And Ben Stewart gets this ball out on the touchline, plays it on quickly.
Big set of six here from the workies. You can see their urgency even then to try and take that kick then. So they can feel that this is an important moment right here for the workies if they're to try and change the game of this first half right here, right now. But let's wait and see what the workies can do as they try and push themselves 40 metres out from the Sims line.
Is this Egan? Egan puts an inside ball to Coops Ali, who's been met by four Sims defenders. That is a strong tackle from the men in the green and goals. Now Coops Ali, he's on his 35-metre line. He plays it. Ernest Allo puts it offload. And he dropped the ball, unfortunately, there. Harry Knight could not spill it. Well, that's probably about six or seven errors already from Lithgow in this half, at least six or seven errors. And unfortunately, most of those errors have been inside Sims' half, which is just halting any momentum that Lithgow are trying to get back in this game. But they are down 6 points to nil with only 5 minutes to go.
Looking at the workies bench, I mean, their heads were down then. They knew that was a big moment. And frustration, I think, kicking in with all these mistakes that we're seeing from the workies at the moment. It's definitely giving the upper hand, you've got to say, to the Sims. As, oh, look at Sullivan, crosses it back over the scrum line here pretty much as they continue to work it.
And he gets out to Ben McAlpine. Prezak tackles McAlpine. Ben Stewart. This is Jerome Harrison trying to get away from Ben Stewart, but Stewart up to the challenge and takes him one-on-one. And he's number five, Robbie Mortimer. He's back, his first year playing for his junior club. And he said, would have loved nothing more than having his older brother, Tim Mortimer, out there. Unfortunately, Tim suffering a season-ending knee injury. He's on the sideline watching from the bench. And now Sims looking to get more upfield. This is Matt Rose to his brother Trent. Trent puts the left foot step on. He gets rid of one defender. He looks around and gets rid of two. This is back to 11. This is Riley Law. And Law runs up to the guts. He's on the 30-minute line. This is right in front of the sticks inside Lithgow's half. What will Sims do? This is the fifth tackle. 4.5 minutes to go. Sullivan goes to the cross kick from the left-hand side. Back to Ben Stewart, and Ben Stewart there and grabs the ball. Great tackle there, by great take by Ben Stewart, but even better tackle there from number four, Ben McAlpine. This is Anthony Ali. He gets rid of one. And he gets tackled there on his 20-metre line. Sims leads 6 points to nil. Not too long till half-time. Here in the Group 10 to his new Premier League Grand Final here at Wade Park. Ben Harris and Brian Vanuatu in the commentary box for Western Rams TV here. So much stronger defence, and I thought, well, we've got a bit of a problem here. Trent Rose has mentioned, signaled to the referee that something is wrong. I think that's Joel O'Brien who is down. Not doing too well. It was a strong tackle from Trent Rose and number 15, Ben Gosper. But with just 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining, and said, Sins have had all the running, haven't they, Brian? And that's why they lead 6 points to nil. Lithgow, bit of errors and ill discipline hurting their momentum and their go forward.
I love how Sullivan for the Sims is really working and dictating the play there in the centre at the moment. He's really trying some new things. Even then, he was running towards the right and then kicked it back over to the left. So he's trying some new things, Sullivan, which is great to see. He's actually working at finding the spaces and really playing within the minds at the moment of the Lithgow workies.
Chris Rose plays the ball on his 40-metre line. This is the last tackle. Stewart kicks it down on the field, and Basman's there. He's let it bounce, and the roll-on has gone straight. It's gone 20 metres inside. Sims is in goal, and Basman has to clean it up, and he runs across field, and he gets, crunching tackle there by the number 14, Steve Lang. He's put a big hit on Tim Basman, but Basman gets up, and he says, oh, it's all right, but Lang, beautiful, great defence, great kick and chase. And this is Matt Rose, looking for the catch up, players offside, looking for support, unfortunately, could not quite get Ben McAlpine in line. And Sims now, they're inside their 35-metre line. Simon Osborne, he puts his jumps up there, gets towards the halfway line. 3 minutes to go until halftime, 6-0, Sims leads Lithgow in the Group 10 to his new Premier League Grand Final for 2015. Sullivan at half. He's looking. It's Ben McAlpine. Up she goes. And there's a big kick. It's a spiraling kick. Cop this end, turning Ali. He takes it. Great take there by the fullback. No pressure. He gets away from two defenders. He runs across field. He gets away from three. Hell, Ali's on the canter. He looks for a great. And he gets tackled down on the 30-metre line. Great attack there by Antonio Ali. It was a high kick from Ben McAlpine. And Ali was up to the challenge. And he made it further 20 metres for his team. And this is Sip Ali. He's been tackled, now on their 40-metre line. 6-0, Sims over Lithgow. On a beautiful day here in Orange's Wade Park. Great crowd here. The grandstand is packed. Underneath the grandstand, there's people everywhere. The hill is... And it's Brendan Van Veen looking for the offload. Can't just get there. Coops Ali was in support. And Wade Egan gives the ball out to the Coops Ali now. On the left, on the right-hand side. This is Egan. Egan at dummy half. He gives it to Ben Stewart. Stewart puts it high up in the air. Basman, another challenge. And here comes the Lithgow defenders. And oh, great take. Oh, unfortunately, Basman spills it. Picked up by number seven by Wade Egan. And this is another great opportunity for Lithgow. Can they hold on? With only 90 seconds to go, Lithgow need to score to get back in this game. It's 6-0. Sims over the workies. They spread it left. And Brendan Van, unfortunately, well, the commentator's curse has struck again. Brendan Van Veen. Trying to look for the quick pass, but fortunately for him, referee Jason Whitney has awarded a penalty for the Sims players for being offside. Lucky break there for workies, would you say, Brian?
Yeah, this kick and chase at the moment from the workies has been absolutely unbelievable because they put it up, they put the pressure on Tim Basman there at the back. They had three on him once again. I tell you what, Tim is really under the pressure there at the fullback because the workies are putting ultimate pressure right on his toes.
And Coops Ali, he gets tackled on the 10-metre line, right in front of the sticks in Sims' half. This is Egan, who puts the left on the left-hand side, trying to fend off the defenders. Unfortunately, he gets brought down by number 11, Riley Law. 3 metres out, left-hand side of the upright. Ernest Arlo gives it to Ben Stewart. Stewart spreads it, holds it onto it. He thought about passing it, but then he gets tackled. And Whitney, well, unfortunately, there's a penalty again. This time, Jason Whitney has given the penalty to the Sims, to the defending side. Ben Stewart running behind his player for an obstruction. And with only 40 seconds to go until half time. Orange Sims lead. Lithgow work is 6 points to nil. Mick Sullivan will just drill this to the sideline. And you have to say that was the last opportunity for Lithgow to put points on the board. They've been down in Sims's half, inside Sims's 20 metres a couple of times, but unfortunately errors and ill discipline, as you saw just then, hurting their momentum, as Robbie Mortimer takes a quick tap and runs hard, gets brought down on the 45 metre line with only a couple of seconds to go until half time. Matt Rose looked like he's going to kick it. Mick Sullivan, he passes it and they're going to spread it wide. This is now 14. This is a score. Scott Sullivan, the 43-year-old, playing. This could be his last game in Sims colours, but and that will do it. Jason Whitney calls half time. The buzzer went. And half time in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final. It's the home side. Orange Sims leading Lithgow Workies 6 points to nil. Brian, synopsis on that first half. Obviously, Sims having a lot of ball inside Lithgow's half. They could have put more points on the board, but Lithgow's defence has been fantastic. But on the other hand, Lithgow, they've had a few opportunities in Sims. Unfortunately, errors and ill-discipline costing them.
Yeah, of course, those errors right at those critical moments for the Workies, right when it means most for them, and they've been dropping it ill, unfortunately, for those guys. So not what they need, the Workies. Sims, though, typically from what we've seen so far in season 2015, fantastic in defence, and they're using that at the moment. They're a little bit under attack, though, with, we were mentioning a moment ago, Tim Basman. He's under pressure with at the fullback there, and then ultimately, though, as well, they've got a little bit of holes out wide, which the Workies are able to try and find at the moment. So that, if they're going to break from anywhere, that might possibly be where the Workies can do it in the second half. But it's going to be a great game. Really looking forward to this second half at the moment. Nice and close, just the way we like it in a grand final. But Sims, home ground advantage and good defence. Got to feel that possibly they can try and get the job done here at home.
Well, 40 minutes down, 40 minutes to go. Only 40 minutes left in the whole season. Orange Sims lead at half time in the Group 10 Premier League grand final. 6 points to nil. We'll be back shortly on Western Rams TV for the second half. Welcome back to the Western Rams TV's coverage of the 2015 Tui's New Group 10 Premier League Grand Final. The sides are coming up for the second half. Orange Sims leading Lithgow Werribee 6-0. Ben Harris and Brian Vanuatu in the commentary box for Western Rams TV. Brian, as Lithgow Werribee's come out, what do you reckon the talk was at half time for both sides?
Just trying to, I think, continue to work it out wide. That's where the Orange Sims seem to be a little bit lacking at the moment, is out wide. And the kick and chase has been fantastic for them so far, really putting pressure on Tim Basman. And Tim, of course, is still searching for that first try in season 2015. Hasn't been over the line yet, but it's going to be tough, I think, to break through this this Werribee side for Basman. He's been under the pump so far, but yeah, kick and chase has been very, very good for the Werribees, and just trying to work it out wide once again. But the man that I'm really interested in at the moment is Mick Salvin, really working in that first half for the Orange Sims, trying a lot of different stuff there, and it's going to be a fascinating second half.
Errors and ill discipline hurting Lithgow Werribees. Graham Osborne probably would have mentioned that. What would they have to do to get back in this game?
For the Werribees, look, it's tough, isn't it? I mean, mistakes is something that often gets spoken about in grand finals because of the pressure and because of the nerves. So hopefully that settled a little bit for them. Basically, you don't plan for mistakes. That's the thing. So, you know, you just got to try and keep the focus on and make sure that that doesn't come through in this second half. But I think the Werribees have got something here for Sims, but we're going to have to wait and see what's going to plan out.
Well, in good signs for Sims, in grand finals the last 5 years, the team that has leading and half time has gone on to win the grand final in Group 10. So history is on the side for Sims, and as a wobbly kick kicks off, he's been brought down. It looks like it's Steve Lang down there. As Jolo, that's Brizak, who runs the ball back from dummy half. Chris Rhodes, he's been very strong so far for Lithgow Werribees, always has been. He leads the pack by the front, and this is Coops Ali. He gets brought down on his 40 meter line, and they're going to kick early. This is Ben Stewart. He darts the kick straight down. Robbie Mortimer. He runs back. He collects it on his 10 meter line, and he runs across field, looking at a way of a war of Lithgow defenders, and he's been brought down just outside his 20 meter line. Basman at dummy half gives out to Scott Sullivan. As at the 43-year-old, unfortunately, in 2010, in the Premier League Grand Final in 2010, when Sims defeated Mudgee 23-16, Sullivan only lasted 15 minutes. He was, you could say, asked back by his younger brother Mick to play one more season this year, and already he's come off the bench. A great stalwart from the Sims club. This is Matt Rose. He comes back across the left. A little bit of sharp shimmy. Gets rid of about three defenders. He passes it on. This is Samesi Katoa off the right foot. He's met hard there by Chris Rhodes, Jono Van Veen, and Jono's brother Brendan in a tackle. As Orange Sims lead 6-0. And Matt Rose comes across here. He puts in. He gets shrugs off a couple of defenders. He passes back on. This is Ben McAlpine. McAlpine to Sullivan. Sullivan, right foot kick, back behind the line. And Tony Ali has to chase it. Good kick up from the bootlaces just there. And he runs across the field. He's looking great through. He's through again. Frankos, and that's a great tackle there by Robbie Mortimer. And he's, unfortunately, Robbie's down injured. And it's probably not a good time at this time, because we do have a special guest in our commentary box. Felicity Neverry is going to be with. She's got a special guest in the commentary box with her, and unfortunately, is a relation to Robbie Mortimer. Unfortunately, great timing. Over to you, Felicity.
Yes, thank you, Ben. I've just got Daniel Mortimer with me right here, so we'll just try and see, hopefully, what's your sort of breakup of how Robbie is out there.
I don't know. He's a tough kid, so I don't think he lays down for anything. He looks like an ankle problem, poor little bugger, so hopefully he can get up and walk it off.
Yeah, well, he's hoping while he's down, we might just give a bit of a sort of brief of how your perspective of the game is so far.
Yeah, that's good. They're both obviously very good teams, and the two best teams all year, and the defence has been outstanding by both teams today. There's not many opportunities, only 6-0, and I think the defence, whoever defends the best is going to win this game. So yeah, it's going to be a close one.
There's been a sort of maybe a few drop balls sort of in the first half, particularly maybe from Lithgow. Do you think maybe it might be a bit of the heat hurting the big pack
there? Yeah, it was quite hot today. Yeah, everyone's saying that it's been a cold winter, but this is the first real hot day they've had. So, yeah, they've got a big pack. It's starting to cool off now, so they might be getting their breath back, the workies. But, yeah, hopefully the Sims can hold on.
And so what do you think that... we'll win the match in this second half?
Yeah, honestly, look, the Sims are in front. They don't need to do anything special, just defend and work hard for each other. I think they'll hold on, but the workies are definitely a talented side.
And obviously, you've got a bit of family sentiment out there on the field. Unfortunately, Tim's not playing, but still on the sideline. What might it mean, for the Sims club, for these guys out here in their 70th year to take home the premiership?
Yeah, and it never matters what grade or what age you are, winning grand final is special. So they've had a very successful time, the Sims, over the last few years. But, yeah, hopefully they can do it again this year. It's a big year for the club. They've been on top of the table all year. But there's 36 minutes to go.
And just quickly, how is it to be back home in the town of Orange?
I absolutely love getting home. The old man's got the winery out here, and relax on the farm and get away from the hustle and bustle of footy, the season that it brings, and just kind of recharge the batteries, I guess.
And so do you have a tip, a scoreline that you might want to divulge?
I think I'm tipping Sims get one more try. It'll be 12-0 full time.
And just quickly, what's next for Daniel Mortimer?
Yeah, still signed on at the Gold Coast next year. We've got a few players leaving, but a few young signings and a lot of good young boys coming through. So, yeah, fingers crossed we can finish the season well and make those finals next year.
Great. All right. Thanks for your time. Hopefully Robbie's all okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Felicity. Thank you to Daniel Mortimer, the Gold Coast Titans half, for taking time out to come out and watch from watching his brothers play and his junior club as well from playing to take time out to talk to Western Rams TV. And that's a great, beautiful Sip Ali tries to get the run, but it's a great bootlace tackle there by Mick Sullivan, another former NRL rake. But yeah, obviously no love lost there from older brother, younger brother, Robbie Mortimer. Looks he's all right. He's trying to look like a leg injury off by now. With 35 and a half minutes to go in the second half, Orange team still lead Lithgow Workies 6 points to nil. Workies have the ball. They're on their 30-metre line. This is Coops Ali. He looked for the inside ball, linking up with his brother Antonio. Unfortunately, Coops could not get the ball away. If Antonio was away, I'm sure it would have been shut the gate. And Wade Egan puts a little chip through. He regathers. This is going to be a great try. Gives it Brendan Van Veen. Van Veen's away. He's over the 10. He's got a score. Lithgow hit back. But you can put that try down to Wade Egan. A terrific chip and chase. Regathers to Brendan Van Veen. And try scores. And Lithgow have now scored. It's Orange Sims 6, Lithgow 4. Well, that's what Lithgow wanted. 5.5 minutes gone in the second half. Brendan Van Veen, he had scored. That's his 17th try of the season. Great, great try for the 30-year-old. A great clubman for Lithgow. He didn't play last year for the Workies. Obviously, his brother Jono, Jono had that 16-month suspension, so he didn't play as well, and Brendan didn't play, and that kind of hurt Lithgow a little bit because they missed the finals. But both those Van Veen boys are back, and you can tell how important those two players are. Brendan Van Veen, great support, and I've got to say Wade Egan, great vision to kick the ball. They chip the ball over, regather, and Brendan Van Veen on his left-hand side. Egan offloads it to Van Veen, and Van Veen runs 30 metres to score to get Lithgow back in this game. And it was a desperate score they needed, Lithgow. It was a desperate try. And now Jono Van Veen, 15 metres out, 10 metres from the goalpost. He slots it. It's gone straight between the dicks, straight between the sticks, over the black dot. And now we're locked up. Brian Van Der Walker, we're locked up with 7.5 minutes gone in the second half. Sims 6, Lithgow 6.
Yeah, what a fascinating game we got here now with just over half an hour to go. 6 all locked up. Workies, they were able to find that breakthrough in the end, and a great try for the Workies. So really opened up the game here at the moment. Sims were lacking a little bit then in defence for a moment. So now that the game's opened up, we're set for a thrilling thrilling end to this match. It's going to be a real fascinating. And let's see what happens to Sims now, because that try was scored for the Workies. I wonder if that just puts a little bit of fire in the bellies now for the Sims to see if they can try and come back. But a little bit awkward there as the ball comes off the post. But it's going to be fascinating, this last 30 minutes of Group 10 for 2015.
Well, it was definitely the shot in the arm Lithgow were searching for, and they needed it, I must say. He came down, and they only had a couple of opportunities in the first half, and unfortunately, ill discipline and errors cost them. But on that occasion, great vision by Wade Egan, and a chip and chase regathered. And we see a penalty from Coops Alley, and Coops Alley pats the steward, Scott Sullivan, on the head and saying, "Thanks very much, buddy. We'll have that penalty, and we'll kick straight down the sideline into touch and get more territory."
There's a fair bit of stick and niggle out there at the moment between the two sides, and you can see that just heading towards the end of the first half as well. So things start to heat up, you know. We've got everything starting to rise, isn't it? The energy levels at the moment. So it's going to be interesting to see how it pans out, I suppose you would say, towards the second half of this game. But yeah, things are starting to get a little bit hot out there.
Yeah, and that's just the weather. Now Thorne, there's a lost ball there. Oh, it's been raked. Well, I did see the ball drop from the grasp of the Lithgow player. Jason Whitney, the referee, has awarded it's a penalty for a rake. And now 20 metres out, I know it is, well, there's still heaps of time left in this game. 20 metres out, I thought Lithgow might be going for the two. Well, they look like they're going for the two. No, they're going for the tap, so they're going to run it. They're going to the attack. And it says Coops Arley, who's had a strong game. He's played for the last 25 minutes so far. He's been really strong. He decided, and having just said that, he's decided to come off. He's going to be replaced by Chris Rhodes. And there's another penalty. Well, back-to-back, back-to-back-to-back penalties for Lithgow. They were down on their own 20-metre line. And now a trifecta of penalties for the Workies has seen them now attacking Sims' 10-metre line. And Brendan West, he just barges over Sam Hill, but credit to Sam Hill, hang on to the bootlaces and brought the big fella down. This is now to Egan. Egan puts the inside ball. The Van is over again. Is he? Yes, he is. Oh no. Hold the phone. Jason Whitney has disallowed the try. It must have been, well, I think Brendan Van Veen, by the way that Whitney was, the referee was signalling, Van Veen has dropped the ball over the line. And now Sims have a 20-metre tap and they take it out. This is through Mick Sullivan, who bad pass there, who's looking for his older brother Scott. But it's being picked up by number three, Jerome Harrison. But Lithgow, unfortunately, that would have been a huge, huge shift in momentum if that try was awarded for Brendan Van Veen, and Lithgow would have been up by four or maybe six if the kick was successful.
We talk about moments in grand finals, and that's one that's going to be spoken about for a number of weeks, isn't it, Ben? The big moment for the Van Veens. Haven't they played a big part in this game?
Here we go. So, yeah, Ryan and Mick Sullivan puts it great through, and he's flying through his team. Bassman looking for his first try of the year. Bassman's there. He scores. Bassman scores. Sims have hit the lead, and just like that, they go from coast to coast. And Tim Bassman, what a way to score your first try for 2015. Mick Sullivan, he breaks the break, puts a little kick in, and the fullback, Tim Bassman, has scored a terrific try for Sims, and they lead 10 points to 6.
Yeah, Timmy Bassman, not only what a moment to score, but what time that was for the Sims, because now they'll squeak the margin out by at least 4 points. We'll wait and have to see what the conversion's going to be like. But Timmy Bassman breaks through for season 2015, and what a time to do it, just when the Sims need it, with just under half an hour to go here in the grand final for the Group 10 Rugby League at Wade Park. But Timmy Bassman, good on him, finally gets over the line for season 2015, and the crowd, got to say that too, the crowd went absolutely wild when he did it. I haven't seen Wade Park lit up like that. Well done, Timmy finally gets one for 2015. He won't have to do the nudie run no more.
He won't have to do the nudie run. I said, Timmy Bassman, in 2012, he was named the Group 10 Player of the Year. He was scoring tries at will. He's been in a drought in 2015, but I got to say, and you're right, Brian, what a time to get off the duck. Great try, but again, Mick Sullivan, he's starting to make his mark on this game. He scored a try early in the first half. And then he made that break. He's put the little chip through. And Bassman, he's kicked it ahead, towed it ahead. And then he ran the run the weight race to the football. And he plants it down. Need lead 10-6. Ben McAlpine, 2 metres from the sideline. 25 metres out. He's on the far sideline from the grandstand. He strikes it. The ball's coming around. It's gone wave to the, across the uprights. And unfortunately, he could not add the extras. So Orange Sims, with 27 and a half minutes to go here in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final for 2015. The home side, Orange Sims lead Lithgow Workies 10 points to 6. As Ernest Allo, he gets us underway. And it's ball's going to go too deep, and that is out on the full. Well, that is the second time today that Lithgow have kicked the ball out on the full from the kickoff. And now, well, just while we were talking about the momentum shifting towards Lithgow, when Brendan Van Veen thought he had his second for the day, in a blink of an eye, Sims have scored, and now they're going to have a terrific opportunity to post their third try of the day. As Ben McAlpine kicks that ball in the touch, he finds it on the 30-metre line, and Lithgow's 30-metre line. And we're looking for Trent Rose. He's had a strong game. A big hit there, and Steve Lane, like a pinball, bounces off Trent Rose. Trent Rose has had a fantastic game so far. He's been very strong. Great tacklers as well. Now here's Simon Osborne. He gets wrapped up by three Lithgow defenders. I can stiff another try. Sims can stiff another try as well. If they can get this, if they can get their third with 26 and a half minutes to go, it will be very, very hard for Workies to come back. As Chris Rhodes takes a bit of time to get off Kieran Bubb. Sammy Hill goes for half. He gets brought down. 2 metres short of the line. Lithgow, what can their defence can do? Remember, attack wins games, defence wins titles. Workies, can they defend this? Mick Sullivan shifts it from right back to the left. Matt Rose, he gets tackled. Offload back to Sullivan. Sullivan looks at the inside. Unfortunately, Trent Rose can't link up. Referee Whitney says it's gone back, and Trent Rose cleans up. He gets through one tackle, but he gets tackled there on the 15-metre line. This is the fifth tackle now for Orange Sims. What will they do? Matt Rose, who puts a little grubber kick in, and Brendan Van Veen dives on the ball, and they're going to get a dropout. Another set of six of Orange Sims. Well, Lithgow Workies, in the last couple of minutes, are just under the pump. Orange Sims are starting to turn these screws around.
Yeah, Orange Sims now have changed this game around in the space of 5 minutes here at the moment at Wade Park. It's going to be another set of six that Lithgow are going to have to try and defend here. They weren't successful 5 minutes ago. They were just then, but I tell you what, this is going to be tough now to try and hold Sims out. The crowd are getting into it now as well, which is a huge, huge thing for the Orange Sims here at the moment. So Lithgow really under the pump now, and this is where Sims can really win this tie.
Well, you can just say that someone's going to step up in the moment. Mick, and that's a wobbly old kick. Not a really good dropout there from Ernest Allo, I've got to say. But this is an opportunity for someone to step up. Who could it be for Sims? Could it be Mick Sullivan? Could it be Trent Rose? Could it be Matt Rose? Or maybe Tim Bassman, who's scored a try already? Could he make a double for Lithgow? I'm looking for one of their big players in Chris Rose, even Brendan Van Veen. And Sims trying to get over the line, but quite not. The game is poised. What's going to happen? 24 and a half minutes to go. Sims lead. Lithgow 10 points to 6. Sullivan inside ball to Bassman. Bassman gets tackled 15 metres out. Sullivan goes from half. He goes to the left. Inside ball to Matt Rose. Matt Rose comes with the right hand. Oh, there's a high shot there, unfortunately. Well, it looked like a high shot. Rose was taken, and in the process, Rose has dropped the ball. And now this is Antonio Ali, who picks up and gets rid of about one or two defenders. Eventually, he's brought down on his 20-metre line by Sam Hill and Kieran Bubb. And this is Jono Van Veen. Big run there, but he's met by a wall of defence, led by Kieran Bubb, the young 23-year-old. Ernest Allo does a little step. Wade Egan at dummy half. He scoops the ball one-handed. Does a little dummy. He's trying to get brought through. Remember, it was Wade Egan's kick and chase that set up Brendan Van Veen, who scored Lithgow's try. Now this is Antonio Ali. Gives it out to Ben Stewart. They're running it on the last. Chris Rhodes gets tackled there. Now it's the last tackle. He's on the right. They're on the 40-metre line. Back to Stewart. Stewart goes to the air. Bassman and Katoa, they're communicating. Katoa takes a great take by Samesi Katoa. safe as a house, and he breaks through one tackle, but eventually gets brought down on the 20-metre line. He plays it. Crowd, the Sims crowd calling for Lithgow to get back on side, but referee Jason Whitney doesn't pay attention to it. Sam Hill from dummy half. The crowd can sense something magical about to happen. They're going to be witnessing something very, very shortly. We've had some terrific grand finals. Who can forget the 2009 grand final where Mudgee was down by 13 points with only 10 minutes to go against Lithgow, and the Dragons winning 32 points to 29. Corin Smith, who now plays for Newtown Jets in New South Wales Cup, scoring right on the bill. As Mick Sullivan takes a big aerial route, huge kick there, and it's Joel O'Brien takes it there, and he gets tackled, takes it on the 20-minute line, and takes it on 25 on his 25-minute and gets tackled there. This is Killian Brizak. He's from dummy half. As said, Brizak came in at the last minute for Kieran Croft. Croft was ruled out prior to the game with a hamstring injury. Alex Byrne, wearing the purple boots. Strong run again. Makes it to the 40-minute line on Lithgow. Wade Egan at dummy half. He's looking for support. Egan calling for the referee's whistle. To no avail. John Van Veen playing centres, but he's running like a prop forward at the moment. He gets inside Sims' own half. He plays it on the 45-metre line. Egan, he's looking for support. Offload to Brendan Van Veen. Great run, and Van Veen is through. Egan's in support. Egan's put the clean pair of heels on. Egan's got a score. It's a great try. Well. Egan provided the support for Brendan Van Veen. And Lithgow have hit back to level this score 10-all with 21 and a half minutes to go. A kick to gum, a terrific try there, Brian, from Lithgow, but set up this time by Brendan Van Veen and Wigan and Wade Egan in support, and he scores right in the corner for Lithgow to level this up 10-all.
Once again, of course, Lithgow, they're just finding those small little margins, those little outpours in the Orange Sims defence. They're able to get through that and break away once again. For the second time, we've seen that happen in this match. So Sims really getting caught in arrears there towards the defensive line. So they've got to really be careful of that. Now, this is going to be a real tough kick here for the workers if they're going to try and edge in front here with 20 minutes to go. But this is setting up for a great finish here at Wade Park.
Well, it certainly is going to be a great finish here, grandstand finish, excuse the pun. As now Jono Van Veen, during the regular season, Van Veen kicked 38 goals. This one, probably his toughest and probably most important one of the season. He is 22 metres out. He is half a metre from the sideline on the grandstand side, on the commentary side. We have a perfect position to see if Van Veen can kick the goal. He runs in, lines up. He unfortunately shanks it, much to the delight of the Orange Sims faithful. And we're locked up with only 20 minutes to go. Orange Sims 10, Lithgow Workies 10.
How good is this, eh? Now we're all square, 20 to go, 10 all. This is going to be good. That you can hear the fans, they're really getting into this, trying to egg their side home, but this is going to be a great finish. I'm really looking forward to this one.
Well, you would not expect anything else from these two teams. They've been the best teams all season. They finished 1-2 with Sims winning the minor premiership. They are locked up 10 all, 19 and a half minutes to go. These two teams have probably been, in the last 10 years, the most successful clubs in the Group 10 for the last 10 years. As I said, Lithgow now, they won their last title was in 2012. They did win a title 10 years ago, and this is their 7th grand final in 11 seasons.
It's funny, Ben, how things actually changed, because Lithgow Workies, albeit 5 minutes ago, looked on top of this game. You would have sworn that the margin was actually bigger in this game, more than 4 points. And now, all of a sudden, Workies were able to find one breakthrough. That's all they've needed. And now the momentum has completely shifted. So this is how much this game, it's been on a pendulum throughout the whole 80 minutes so far. And once again, not a great kick there as they go up in search of the ball. And Workies get away with it once again.
Brizak there, gets tackled there, but unfortunately that was the last, and there's a bit of a changeover in the possession. 18 and a half minutes to go. Orange Sims 10, Lithgow Workies 10. Ben Harris and Brian and Van and Waka in the commentary box for Western Rams TV. We've had a fantastic day here in Orange. at Wade Park in the league tag. If you just join us in the league tag, Bathurst St. Pat's defeated the defending premiers, Bathurst Panthers, 14 points to 4. In the under 18s, Orange Hawks defeated Mudgee Dragons, 42 points to 12. And in the first division, Orange Sims went back to back. First time a team has gone back to back in nearly 8 years in the first division competition. They defeated Bathurst Panthers, 10 points to 6. Now, Orange Sim, the club itself, we were looking for 2 from 2 in terms of titles and possibly 3 from 3 in terms of Orange clubs. Sims gives out the Sutherland, puts a short ball out to Ben McAlpine. They have been dangerous, those two. Dangerous pairing, Sullivan and McAlpine. As Matt Rose puts a little grubber kick. Unfortunately, it's been cleaned up by Chris Rose. And in the process, well, that is... Well, I know they've got the rub of the green. And I know Orange are wearing green, but... Chris Rhodes, he did so well to dive on that ball, but he's knocked the ball on, and now with only 17 and a half minutes to go, Sims have the ball right in front of Lithgow's uprights, 35 metres out from the Lithgow line.
Yeah, a bit of luck there for the Sims, and of course that's the way their first try came earlier on in the game with Mick there. Mick Sullivan getting through a little bit of luck as well. He did one of those little grubber kicks that came off of work, his player, and straight back into his own hands, so... It's going to be interesting to see how luck could possibly play on the Sims side now, but this is a big set of six in the terms of the context of the match. If Lithgow workers can try and hold them out, they've had, you know, the momentum in the final past 5 minutes, and if they can hold that here at the moment, then you feel that Sims are maybe just getting dragged back a little bit, but they've got the chance right here, right now.
Sullivan to Rose. Rose links up with Matt, with Trent. Trent back to Matt. Matt, look on the inside. This is Jerome Harrison. He gets brought down. Well... Harrison, he gets on the collar, gets brought down by the collar. Robbie Mortimer, that's Matt Rose, puts a little cover kick in and has been dived on. Has it inside the in goal? No, it hasn't, but it has been dived on by Lithgow workies. And that, and well, what's happening here? Whitney, in fact, I thought that was the case. I thought I was seeing things. I thought the Lithgow player had dived on the ball inside the in goal. And Jason Whitney has pointed for a goal line dropout, and that's going to hurt Harry Knight, who was the person that who grounded the ball inside the goal, as the referee calls time off with 16 minutes left on the clock. It's Orange Sims 10, Lithgow Workies 10 in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final for 2015.
And once again, a different sort of play from Sims, actually kicking earlier in that set of six that time. And we've seen Sullivan really mixing it up a lot. And
oh, sorry, Bear Brian. And unfortunately, well, we're talking about the rub of the green for Sims. Well, now Lithgow have got the rub on the green. That dropout kick drilled to the sideline, and Trent Rose could not stop it. He tried to stop it with his feet, but it's gone straight in a tunnel, the Harbury Bridge, underneath his legs. And now Lithgow, on their own 30-metre line, have the ball.
Sims will be frustrated by that, because that was another wobbly kick then from the Lithgow workies, and something that the Sims really should have picked up on all right then. So, once again, frustrating. And let's see if Lithgow workies can try and make something if of this late in this half of the moment as they work it over their 40-metre line. But this is about the position where the Sims were able to, weren't able to hold on last time through, and where the workies were able to squeak on through as there's a juggly act as they get up to their halfway line.
15 minutes to go. Orange Sims 10, Lithgow Workies 10, here at Orange's Wade Park for the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final for 2015. Ben Harris and Brian Vanawaka in the commentary box for Western Rams TV here for you. Workies inside Sims' half. They're on their 35-metre line. This is Allo. Here's the Egan. Egan to Stewart. Stewart links up with Brendan Van Veen. Back to Antonio Ali. Great slide tackle there. That's Jerome Harrison, the centre for Sims. He breaks down, and Brizak comes through and makes a 15-minute run. He passes the ball back. Is that play on? And there is play on. Fifth tackle there. Egan passes off right there to Sip Ali. Wait, no, it's gone forward. Well, I thought there was a bit of a scramble match there. I thought Sims might have knocked that ball on and would have been six to go. Nonetheless, Jason Whitney said it was the last tackle, and Wade Egan, great vision again from the young 18-year-old, the youngest player on this pitch. Wade Egan is actually still eligible, believe it or not, Brian, to still play for the under-18s this year. But Coach Graham Osborne said, no, we want him as our number 7 for Premier League, and he has not taken a step back, I can tell you that now. But unfortunately, his pass to Sep Ali, the wrecking ball for Lithgow, just travelled forward, and now Sims have the ball on their own 30-minute line. This is Sam Hill, who runs from dummy half and gets tackled on his own 35-metre line.
What a big call, because once again, Orange just hung out to dry a little bit on their wings at the moment. That's where the holes are. Lithgow being able to work
and it. Trent Rose makes a break. Sorry, Brian. Here we come through. Play on. Gives it out to... There's six to go again. Has been brought down there. I'm not sure. That's, I think it's Wayne Collett over there. It is to number 17 wearing the blue boots. Here's Osborne. Here alongside. And Osborne crawls his way to the line. He's just short. 2 metres, 2 metres from the line. Hill to Matt Rose. Looking for support. He finds Mick Sullivan. Sullivan, long ball out to Riley Law, who puts it back on the inside. Kieran Bob, who passes inside. Picked up again by Sullivan. Sullivan crashed tackle down on the 8-metre line. Here we go. 12 and a half minutes to go. Sims on the attack. Lithgow, what tech can the fence can do? Matt Rose, he runs back to the right. He's looking for a link up of support, and he gets... Gets off Brendan Van Veen's tackle. He's still going, Matt Rose. Someone tackle him. Ben McAlpine. Bassman looking at number two. Oh, what a try. What a try. Sam Hill. He's always there for in the support. And just like that, Orange Sims hit the lead through Sam Hill. And great pickup there by the hooker. But a terrific offload from Tim Bassman. Now Sims lead 14 points to 10.
Offload of the season. Tim Bassman, what an offload. Puts it in for the Sims. And I tell you what, we might just be saying that that is the moment of the season there. Timmy Bassman, what an offload. He's scored a try today. He's put off an offload. What a day the fullback is having for the Orange Sims. And now he's going to give them a 4-point lead, possibly six, if they can make this conversion successful. You've got to feel that they can, because it's not too far away from the middle of the sticks there. But oh, Timmy Bassman, what an offload.
That could be the play of the game, if not the play of the season. Terrific support by Sam Hill. I've got to say, Sims weren't going anywhere on that set of play. Matt Rose was coming left and right, eventually passed it back up on the left hand side, and Bassman made a break. He saw the line. He did a flick pass behind him to Sam Hill, and Sam Hill went over the line untouched. Now with 11 and a half minutes to go, Ben McAlpine, only 10 metres from the goal, from the post, strikes it, and unfortunately he misses it. Well, just as we thought Ben McAlpine was going to slot this home, there's a new twist into this game, and I'm not sure about you, Brian, but I'm pretty sure there's about one or two, if not more, twists to come in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, and the Sims will get it back underway once again, but still, Timmy, what? I can't get over that offload. That was an absolute cracker over there. He's setting up that try there for the Orange Sims, but yeah, the Lithgow workies, let's see if they can try and work it out and hopefully not put it out in the full as they get play underway once again.
I got to say, that try meant so much to the Sims. Oh! Cop that! That is Sep Ali on a prop forward, ladies and gentlemen. Sep Ali is a winger. He just polarized Cam Jones, and Ali gets up and says, cop that! I was just about to say, Orange, that try to Sam Hill meant so much to Orange Sims. Their bench went up as one and started hugging and high-fiving each other. But Sep Ali might have just wrestled back the momentum towards Lithgow with that huge hit. That's what they need. They need a bit of shot in now, not that.
Sims can't start getting complacent with themselves, though, because Lithgow workies, as we've seen many times throughout this grand final, as soon as the Sims appear to be actually on the front foot and looking quite pretty, workies in the space of a heartbeat have been able to churn it around, and here we go once again.
Well, that ball didn't go as far as Matt Rose wanted. It went really high. Probably went higher than it went as far as distance-wise. And Sep Ali, you can't give this man the room. This is Antoni Ali, I'm not going to say. You can't give either Ali boys any room to move, because they're so quick and elusive as well. This is number 18. This is Mitch Case. Big hit. Well, Simon Osborne has said, well, mate, if your teammate's going to smash my one, I'm going to smash you. And Osborne gets up and says, come on, Case, let's have another go. Mitch Case brought in at the last minute for Kieran Croft. Kieran Croft was out injured prior to the game with a hamstring injury. Case wearing number 18. As now Licker on the 30-metre line, inside Sims half. That's Ben Stewart, who's been brought down. Egan, he goes, does a little chip to the chase. He's chasing Casey Reed Gavin. No, great take there by Sullivan. Mick Sullivan held his own. He knew Wade Egan, was coming. And Sullivan up to the challenge, gets the ball, and now Sims, they're trying to work it outside their own half. They're on the 37-metre line.
Bright idea there from Egan, you've got to say, to go for that chip and chase. He almost made it work, and that would have been the moment there for the workies. I'm just looking now at Sullivan. He's still down at the moment, that number 7 for the orange Sims, so fingers crossed it's okay, and hopefully it's just a cramp or something there in the calf muscle.
Keep your eye on that, Brian, as there'll be a big loss if Sullivan does come off. He might be cramping. He has had a bad history with injuries, especially coming to Sims since 2010. He's missed plenty of games. And Brendan West, well, that looked like an eternity that Brendan West was on Matt Rose. The crowd not happy. Whitney, the referee, has just said, get up and play it. Mick Sullivan still, he's still having those, he must be cramped because he's still trying to stretch it out. He's put a little grubber kick in. This is Steve Lang. He gets tackled on the 30 metre line, I must say. Now Lithgow, they are down 14 points to 10. 7 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the 2015, I should say, to his new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final. It's been a terrific match so far. Tight tussle. This is Coops Ali. He gives it offload up to Tony Ali. This is Jono Van Veen here with the ball. He runs the ball. It's been a great one-on-one contest between himself and Ben McAlpine, former Group 10 Premier League. And just like that, well, Ben McAlpine has put down Jono Van Veen for a second attempt, for a second tackle. And Lithgow get a penalty. And Jono Van Veen has kicked that into touch on the 25 metres out of Liv Sims' line. This is Egan back to Cooper's Ali now. And he gets tackled on the 20-metre line. Workies, four points behind Sims. They trail 14-10, 6.5 minutes to go. And just, oh dear. If I was Graham Osborne, I would be pulling my hair out right now because that was a fantastic opportunity for Lithgow to get another try and to even level the scores, even not take the lead. But Brendan West has knocked the ball on, and the reaction from the workies bench said it all. Hands went straight to their heads. Some of them were shaking their heads at the same time. But this is Wayne Collett. He gets brought down on his own 20-metre line. 6 minutes to go. Sims lead Lithgow, 14 points to 10. It's been a fantastic grand final, I must say. Been a great day here at Group 10 at Wade Park. Bathurst St. Pat's winning league tag 14-4 over Panthers. 18s Hawks defeating Mudgee 42 points to 12. And in first division, Sims defeating Bathurst Panthers 10 points to 6. But in the big game here, we've got Sims 14 against Workies 10. And Brendan Van Veen, who was might have been trying to take down Mick Sullivan, but the two get up and have a bit of a laugh and a bit of a rub each other's head. Obviously, they are, you know, Group 10 and Western Rams ex-teammates. And Lithgow now. This is the fifth tackle. Sims are on the 45-metre line. Matt Rose goes straight to the air. Another spiring kick. And Jono Van Veen under it. But regathered with Ben McAlpine. It's gone travel forward. And Riley Law picks up. But unfortunately, the ball has gone forward. And Sims get a let off there on their own 25-metre line. It's Sims 14, Workies 10. We have 5 minutes to go.
Sims got to be careful here because that was a nice set of six from the Lithgow Workies. That it was just nice, consistent, keeping Orange Sims down in their own half until the kick came through. So let's see what Workies can do with 4.5 minutes to go. This game is certainly not done with yet. And look at the metres that the Workies are making up as they get out to the 40 metres out from their own line.
There's a penalty, and that is a huge, huge call for a huge advantage, I should say, for Lithgow. Big call from Jason Whitney to award a penalty there, but you can't hold on to the player down, especially when you're leading by four in a grand final. Lithgow have a great opportunity now. 14-10, they are down. Can they do it? They've probably got about two more sets before time is up. And Brendan West gets tackled. He's been taken out. Well, I'm speechless. You've got the penalty. You're 30 metres out. 4 minutes to go, you're down by four, and you decide to run towards the sideline. Well, run towards the post, maybe for the next time someone should tell Brendan West, but that is just crucial. That is a crucial mistake from Workies.
Sims have been unbelievable in their defence in 2015, and that is going to be a moment that's going to win them a title for 2015. Fantastic defence from Sims. They've proved it once again, and from 3.5 minutes to go, that is going to be a very pivotal moment in the season of the Orange Sims.
You would hurry up to say Sims have already got two more sets of six, and Lithgow, with only about 3.5 minutes to go, might have one, maybe two, if they're lucky. As now Katoa gets up gingerly. They're gonna slow this down as much as possible, Sims. And why wouldn't you? You're up 14-10. This is Scott Sullivan. He plays it. Will be a great effort by Sims if they can get this win, especially in their club's 70th anniversary. It would put the cherry on top of the cake. They've been successful the last six seasons. As I said, this is their fifth grand final appearance in 6 years. They didn't make the finals last year. They missed out the top five. And now they're on the cusp on winning their fourth title, to say, in 6 years. And Mick Sullivan, well, there's the experience from the former NRL player, the former Sharky and the former Bulldog, just drills that into the sideline. And look at him barking at his troops to tell them, come on, boys, one more set of six and we've got this title wrapped up.
Yep, that's what it's all about. One more set of six. You got to feel now for the Orange Sims to try and defend. This is what their season's been based on, defence, and now this is all they've got to do to try and win season 2015 here at Wade Park this afternoon. It's going to be a tremendous reception, you would say, from this crowd if they can try and get this done. But this is the moment now for the Workies. They need to make something happen deep within their own half.
Well, and don't count out Workies. They can go the distance, as we've seen before. And we've seen in Group 10 Grand Finals before. Think back in 2003 in Orange Hawks. Orange Hawks and Mudgee Dragons. On the last play of the game, Hawks won that game 34 points to 30. Now Lithgow on the 30-metre line. 90 seconds to go. The last roll of dice for Workies, you would have to imagine. This is Brezak. He's been strong today. He's done very well, the young guy that's been thrown in the starting side. The crowd getting up from Sims. Coops Ali looking for that offload. He gives it off, and he gives it to Sep Ali, number five. Lithgow, 45 metres out, last tackle. What can they do? They're Ben Stewart. He goes straight to the air. It hasn't gone far, but all the Lithgow players are standing underneath it. Back to Egan, taps on. Sims have knocked it on, and knocked back with a minute to go. That could be it. That could be it. 60 seconds to go. Orange Sims have the ball inside their half on the 35-metre line. Semezi Katoa takes a tackle. They're getting up slowly, wasting down the clock. And we're knocked on, and Lithgow knocked on, and that is it. That should be it. I can't imagine Sims taking heaps of time to score the line. Lithgow are making the scrum. Are trying to pack the scrum as quickly as possible. Jason Whitney hasn't blown time off yet. We have 20 seconds to go. Sims lead Workies 14 points to 10. They are only minutes of seconds away from winning their fourth title in 6 years. And there's a penalty, and they're all. Well, we saw this in the under-18s game. A bit of a scuffle to end that match, which was won by Hawks 42-12. But it doesn't matter as the full-time siren goes. Sims victorious. 14 points to 10, and here we end. Unfortunately, we don't want this as ugly scenes. I'm not sure there's been any punch. And there's punches thrown. Chris Rose is in the middle. Matt Rose and Antonio Ali are there as well. They've shaped up to each other. There was a Sims player who did throw a punch, but I'm not sure who it was. Chris Rose was there. Well, it's been a fantastic match, and this is just an ugly end to a great game. Chris Rose in his opposite number, Simon Osborne, having words. Well, even though it's full time, Brian, a referee's work is never over, is it? We saw this in the under-18s. And it's happened again in Premier League. Bit of frustration coming from Workies. As I repeat, Sims have won this match 14 points to 10. Their fourth premiership in 6 years. Quite remarkable considering that between 1988 and 2010, it was a 22-year drought before they got another premiership. But when Mick Sullivan has come on board from Sims in 2010, they have played in five grand finals from six and have won four of them. As Jason Whitney, the crowd is yelling their opinion, but referee Jason Whitney and his touch judges Nick Lander and Nathan Blanchard, plenty of experience out of those three. Not sure he's going to have a few words. We don't want any players sent off. As Ben McAlpine, Jason Whitney gets Ben McAlpine to him, and I think that's Scott Sullivan. Well, and Scott Sullivan, well, unfortunately, he's been sent off. The 43-year-old, impossibly his last game for Sims. Not sure if he's going to come back next year. Well, he's been sent off to the sheds. I would have said an early shower, but the game has been, it's full time already, and this has been going for about 2.5 minutes already. Big crowd. Scott Sullivan's got a bit of claret coming from his left cheek. Simon Osborne has been sent off as well. So two players from Sims have been sent off. I must repeat, even though the buzzer has gone, has said the clock is saying it's full time, Jason Whitney has not blown full time, and Ben McAlpine, the captain, has been sent off. There is three players from Sims. I would think any more players sent off from Orange Sims, they would have not enough players to call. But Simon Osborne, he gets applauded for his game. Obviously, they're not applauding for his efforts, but now Jason Whitney calling out Chris Rose, the Lithgow Workies captain. Chris Rose, Corey Wilmot has been sent. I hope you're keeping count. Has anyone got the lucky bingo number? We're up to four so far. And I believe we're going to have number five. Coops Ali. He's been talked by Whitney. And he's gone. Well, is this a record for a Group 10 Grand Final? Five players sent off. This is absolute ridiculous if you ask me.
But I think we're going to have to get on there shortly and play ourselves. There's going to be no one left.
And Chris Rose being sent. So three from Orange Sims, three from Lithgow Workies. Three players from each team have been sent off. And, well, this is gonna be the talking point. And unfortunately, it's been a fantastic time. And as you said, Jason Whitney is going full time. And with that, the Orange Sims players can officially celebrate. They are the Group 10 Premier League champions for 2015, the fourth time in 6 years, the Green and Golds are on top of the mountain. Well, unfortunately, this grand final is going to be remembered for the last 30 seconds of this game, if not three players from Orange Sims and three players from Lithgow Workies sent off, including their respective captains. But Brian Vanuaka, a disappointing end to the game. What was a fantastic grand final, as referee Jason Whitney, that little stink happened out of nothing. I think about a frustration from Lithgow Workies, but 14 points to 10, Orange Sims over Lithgow Workies in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League grand final. Sims minor premiers in 2015, they are now the full-fledged premiers. What did you make of today's game?
Yeah, fantastic result from the Sims, of course. They've been brilliant throughout season 2015. And real deserving champions, you've got to say. I mean, they defended for, you know, good portions of that game. Real, you know, momentum shifts as well at plenty of points. But at the end of it, Sims, you know, they've been fantastic throughout this season. Great defensive structure, and there's going to be a lot of celebrations tonight in Lithgow, that's for sure.
In orange, I should say. It might be some commiserations in Lithgow, I must say. But
it'll be a long drive for them back to Lithgow.
It will be a long drive. As I said, Orange Sims victorious in 2015, 14 points to 10 over Lithgow Workies. Try scorers for today's game. Mick Sullivan opened the scoring in the first half, and they led at halftime, Sims, 6 points to nil. And then Lithgow needed to score first in the second half, which they did, through Brendan Van Veen, a fantastic chip and chase from Wade Egan. And he regathered and gave it to Brendan Van Veen, who scored near the sticks and to tie it up at 6-6. Then just as you thought Van Veen had his second foot today, he looked like he's dropped the ball over the line. And in the next set of six, Sims went from one end to the other, went coast to coast. Mick Sullivan put a little grubber through. He kicked it through, picked it up. Tim Bassman towed it through as well, and then he scored his first try of the season. And what a way to do it in a grand final, to make it 10 points to 6. Then Wade Egan, he scored in the corner to make it 10 points to all. And with only a few moments left in the game, Tim Bassman, a flick pass from the fullback to a supporting hooker in Sam Hill, and Sam Hill ran over the try line and scored untouched to win 14 points to 10. A fantastic season for more clubs, I've got to say. It's been a very, very hard Group 10 season. Orange Sims victorious, 14 points to 10. It's going to be hard for a David Scott medalist. Trent Rose was fantastic. Mick Sullivan was incredible for Orange Sims. Tim Bassman left probably his best game for last. For Lithgow Workies, obviously their young halfback, 18-year-old Wade Egan, he played very, very well. Brendan Van Veen was terrific. But as repeat here, Orange Sims 14, Lithgow 10. Now, Brian Van Der Wacker, I'll get your final thoughts on the match, mate, on the whole situation, especially that ugly scene towards the end where we've seen six plays in total. I'm sure that's a record in a game of football. Six plays, three from each team, sent off in the last few seconds.
There's an old cliche that goes, Ben, and right there within that period of 30 seconds, we had more drama right then than 12 seasons of home and away. So I think that's probably the best way of looking at it. But great scenes here after the match. All the Orange Sims boys and girls getting out there and enjoying with each other. Of course, a fantastic year for them, and congratulations to them. Celebrations galore tonight in Orange, and great scenes right down there at the moment.
Well, in their 70th year, Orange Sims have won the Western Challenge Cup for the fourth time in 6 years. They've been the best team all year. And they deserve a right to win this game, and they deserve to be crowned Group 10 champions. As repeat, Orange Sims defeated Lithgow Workies 14 points to 10 in the Tui's new Group 10 Premier League Grand Final. On behalf of Brian Van Der Wacker, thank you very much for your comments, mate. It's been a pleasure. I am Ben Harris, and thank you very much to you at home or at work or wherever you're listening or viewing this. Thank you for joining us on Western Rams TV. We'll see you next year for the 2016 season. But just repeating, Orange Sims victorious in the Group 10 Premier League Grand Final over Lithgow, 14 points to 10. From Wade Park, it's goodbye.
Thank you.